This audio is brought to you by Muslim Central. Please consider donating to help cover our running costs and future projects by visiting www.muslimcentral.com/donate.
Assalamu alaikum, Quran Weekly. This is Hala Banani, and today I'm going to tell you about the three main ingredients in having a loving marriage. Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulullah. Wa min ayatihi an khalaqa lakum min anfusikum azwajan litaskunu ilayha wa ja'ala baynakum mawaddatan wa rahmah. Inna fi dhalika layatin liqawmin yatafakkarun. And of his signs, wa min ayati, from his signs, and khalaqa lakum, that he has created, min anfusikum, from yourself, azwajan, your spouse, your husband, your wife, litaskunu ilayha, so that you may find tranquility and peace. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ, and he made between you مَوَدَّ وَرَحْمَةً, that he has put between you that love and mercy. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So these are the signs for people who reflect. This is one of the most popular verses used in weddings, and it's so critical for us to reflect on the meaning, not just from a spiritual sense, but also from a psychological perspective, that what is it that Allah is telling us is the recipe for having an amazing marriage. And we can extrapolate some of the most essential marital lessons. Really, Allah is saying here is that the main purpose of marriage is to provide you with peace. Allah is saying that from His signs, you will find peace. It's guaranteed if you follow the guidelines that He establishes. So basically, there are three purposes of marriage, which is peace, love, and mercy. And these are also the three main ingredients for having a successful marriage. When you have a good marriage and husbands and wives are loving and respectful to one another, that affects the way that you raise your kids. The kids are going to be happy and confident, and as a family, they can contribute to the community. When you have broken homes, when there is fighting, when there's yelling, and there's emotional and physical abuse, it really affects the children. And a broken home leads to broken societies. I've had children that they were 15 years old having to stand between their mother and father. The father was about to strike the mom, and the child would have to stand there and try to protect her mother. Imagine how traumatic that is. Imagine how broken this child feels. And so we really need to first focus on the marital relationship, improving that love and that mercy between the husband and wife before we even talk about having children and contributing to the community. Let's start with litaskunu. Sukun, as you know, in tajweed means no movement. There's no haraka. And that means to have mental peace, you need to stop. You need to stop and connect with your spouse. You need to be a source of comfort, support, and understanding for your spouse. And being the first one your spouse will go to for support and comfort. Look at the amazing example of Khadija radiallahu anha, how she was there for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam at his darkest hour of fear and confusion. She was there to put hope and peace in his heart. And imagine her effort, because she was so emotionally stable, because she had worked on herself and she was at such a level of maturity, she was able to be there for her husband, for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it was so admired that she got salams from Allah Azza wa Jal. Her act was so admirable, was so amazing, that it got her to get salams from Allah Azza wa Jal. Anytime I think about that, I get teary-eyed, that what an amazing wife she was. What effort and what comfort she provided the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was at the service of his family. He was a source of peace. He made the peace of the home. If anything came up, he used his wisdom to resolve it in a very diplomatic manner. The majority of people are in turmoil because they lack conflict resolution. Actually, I say conflict resolution is non-existent. It's not the absence of conflict in a marriage, but it's how the conflicts are handled that makes for a great marriage. So basically, there are three steps to conflict resolution. And our objective for conflict resolution is attaining that peace. We want to have the peace because most people, when they don't apply conflict resolution, when they are not communicating effectively, when they are not thinking about the other person, what happens is that they just basically explode. They have a fight and nothing gets resolved. So wanting to do it in a proper manner and having conflict resolution as your objective, you are trying to attain the peace, that very peace that Allah is talking about in this verse that is one of the purposes of marriage. So first thing we need to do is be aware of the timing. When you want to bring up something, you need to make sure that your spouse is not overly tired, they're not stressed out, that they're not preoccupied. Because if you don't keep that in mind and you approach them at the wrong time, what happens? You see that there's an explosion because you're not considering their feelings. You're not considering the fact that they may have a deadline, they're pressured, they're hungry, they're stressed, whatever it is. Maybe they're losing a loved one, maybe they're sick, something is going on. And if you are oblivious to what's going on with your spouse's life or their emotional state, and you just want to resolve the conflict, they will not be open and receptive. So we need to make sure that we approach our spouse at the right time. And the second thing is observe, don't criticize. Observe, don't criticize, meaning what? That if you see something is not the way you like it, you just make an observation. You state that, I noticed that the house has not been maintained. Are you okay? Are you overwhelmed? Is there anything I can do to help? Rather than criticize, saying that you never clean up. I mean, look at this mess. What's wrong with you? You had all day. Why can't you get your act together? You see how that criticism will really feel like an attack, and the person is obviously going to feel defensive. So you make an observation. I noticed that the bills were not paid and we have some late fees. Is there something I can do to help out? Are you feeling a little bit stressed about doing the bills? Can I help out in some way? That's making an observation. You're not criticizing. The criticism would be like, I can't believe how careless you are. You didn't pay the bill, so now we have all these late fees. How can you be so indifferent? Right? So that becomes a personal attack. Being aware of your spouse's emotional state, being aware of timing, observing and not criticizing, you're showing that you are in tune with your spouse. You don't want to hurt their feelings. You don't want to overwhelm them. So this is a form of rahmah. So we said that the conflict resolution, wanting conflict resolution, that has to do with the objective of gaining peace in your home. You're not just going to explode. You want to have a method of resolving your problems. Being aware of the timing and observing, not criticizing, that's all about rahmah, having mercy. The third way is to diffuse the tension. Many times when you get into an argument with your spouse, there's a lot of tension. Everyone feels super sensitive. And so it's really important to find out what would help your spouse release some of the tension. With some sisters, they say, all I need is a hug. If they get hugged at the time of an argument, everything subsides. So they just need a little bit of affection. Sometimes you can agree on using humor. Now be careful. Don't be sarcastic about your spouse. You have to use humor that you know will make your spouse laugh. You're not laughing at them, you're laughing together. And then basically taking some time out, making that a time to maybe just relax, maybe go for a walk, and so that you're not escalating the tension. And of course, there's a lot to discuss about how to come to a compromise, which we don't have time to get into right now, but these are the first primary steps in resolving the conflict. One of Allah's name is Wadud, which is love, and that is one of the names that we need to emulate. This mawadda, this love, it creates a friendship. Love, you have to look at love as a verb, that you need to show your love, you need to express it, you need to do loving acts. It's not just a feeling. A lot of times we focus on the emotional aspect of love, we're just waiting to feel love. Love is a verb, and so we need to express our love by showing it, by doing kind acts, loving actions, which will make your spouse feel love. A lot of times we focus on love as being just a feeling, and we either feel it or we don't. Some people say, I don't feel it anymore, I'm not in love with my spouse. Well, you can't wait for that love. You need to be proactive. You need to create the love. And this love leads to friendship, which is actually the second pillar of the Five Pillars Marriage Program. And they have done studies that those individuals who have been married the longest and they're the happiest in their relationship are the ones who have a lasting friendship. Because when you have a friendship with your spouse, you're respectful, you're loving, you have a good time with them, and that's what makes for a long-lasting relationship. So this is all about mawadda and the love. Now, as far as the rahma, which is the mercy, this is a stronger form of love because it is what makes you feel that need to provide for your spouse physically and emotionally. You want to protect them, you want to provide for them, and obviously if there's mercy, you don't want to hurt them in any way. You don't want to hurt them emotionally or physically. There's that sense of protection from verbal, emotional, and physical abuse. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the Muslim is the one that other Muslims are safe from their tongue, which is sarcasm and criticism, and hands, physical violence. So unfortunately, many marriages are plagued with abuse. Where's the mercy? If you are taking out your anger on your spouse, on the person who is looking to you for protection, for comfort, for peace, then where is that mercy? As a cognitive behavioral therapist, I work on changing the way that people think in order to change their behavior. So if you're thinking negatively about your spouse all day, your heart will be filled with resentment and anger, and it's going to be impossible to be merciful. This destroys your internal peace. So if you're thinking, I can't believe he is so selfish, he is so greedy, I can't believe that he did this, and all day long you're replaying all the negative things that your spouse did, or you're thinking about, how could she be so careless? How could she be so selfish? How could she be so impossible? If you're thinking that all day long, what is that going to do to you? You are going to be filled with anger and resentment, and you're going to become reactionary, and this will make you mess up the external piece of your marriage, right? Whatever is going on through your mind is going to affect your feelings, and those feelings are going to affect your actions. So be really careful about having negative thoughts about your spouse. Now, mercy implies the spiritual connection. It's a spiritual connection that develops when you're married, which causes you to be affectionate, to be sympathetic, and to be loving. And a lot of times we think of marriage as completing half of your deen. And actually what it does is that it will force you to work on your emotional state. It pushes you to develop the compassion, the patience, and the faith. So it really completes that aspect of your deen as well. Many times we view marriage as completing half our deen because it's protecting us from so many of the temptations. It's also completing half of our deen in working on ourselves emotionally because we're pushed to be more compassionate, more patient, and more understanding. I think if we take these three ingredients, the peace, the love, and the mercy, and we apply it into our marriage the way Allah intended for us to experience our marriage, we will all have a better relationship, inshallah.
This audio is brought to you by Muslim Central. Please consider donating to help cover our running costs and future projects by visiting www.muslimcentral.com/donate. Mm-hmm.